Hi there. I'm going to give Amore's toes a quick groom. She is one of my most stressy dogs, so I try to make it quick for her and have a rhythm. I'm going to trim her toenails today. I'm going to trim off the free edge. I'm going to try to avoid nicking the quick here. Then I'm going to do a bit of whittling to get the outside edges off. And when I'm looking at the end of the toe, I'm trying to stay in the pulpy zone. And I'm going to remove the hard edges of her toenail that kind of rounds it off. I'm going to avoid getting too close to the blood supply that'll show up as a change of color in the middle of the toenail. So I'm going to try to stay, like I said, in the pulpy zone. And I'm going to kind of whittle around the blood supply that we call the quick. That's my plan. I'm going to do this with little, poor little Mores. So she worries. And she was a dog I actually really had to try a lot of patience with. And here we go. Oh, I've taught her to bang, so she's going to remain in this down position. Off with the free edge. I'm going to do a little bit more. I can see the color change. I'm going to do my whittling. Doesn't take but a second or two. I'm going to move to the next toe. Free edge, whittle in, have a look. I'm as close as I want to get to that quick. It hasn't been a super long time since I've done Morse's toes. And I want to give it that whittling bit so that what it does is it actually helps. As the nail recovers from the clipping, it hardens at the end of the toenail and it pushes the quick back a little bit. So here we go, free edge, my top whittle, side whittles, and I find this is so much easier to maintain. Oh, did I tickle you? When I've got a regular grooming routine with the dog, it's difficult that first time to try to find the quick without nicking into it. I can have a look. Okay, so I nicked into this quick a little bit. Just gonna put some stuff on it. That's my quick stop. I know it. See, my quick stop. Whoop, there we go. Quick stop. And move right along. You'll see my dog's okay with it. She's not happy, but she's not in crisis mode. Okay, free edge. The top piece. I can see the change of color in there. I didn't need to do the left side. Okay. You know, I always try to make my first snip at an angle so that there's room for the toenail as she walks, because toenails are not retracted. So I need to have the toenail short enough that it's off the ground when she stands, and that there's room as her foot rolls forward and she walks for that nail to not be putting too much pressure on the toe, because that's what causes the arthritis. Dislocated toes. Okay, free edge. Do my little whittles. Free edge. I know, poor Morris. She says, I had enough. All right. So, coming to a close. I don't have dew claws on this dog. We did good. Nails are slightly rounded from the side. Rounded this way. And rounded this way. So that's the plan. Her toes aren't too bad for needing trims. Look, you survived. That's a quick trim. Thanks for watching. Part two of Amore's quick tidy up today is going to be just going over the feet hairs a little bit. So I've got my favorite scissors and my slicker brush. I'm going to just have a go. Oh, so my plan is straight across the front of the toes, and I'm just going to come down the series of pads. I'm going to help pull this ahead a little bit. I'm going to work. You'll notice my scissors are level to the pads. I'm not digging in. I don't have to go in between the toes much. But I'm sort of moving my scissors along in a way that I cover the ground, sweeping them across the toes. Now I'm going in between toes. A little bit, just moving the toe around, because I don't want to leave too much in between. I know it tickles, doesn't it? I know. So here's one of my tricks, is that when I push the toes ahead, I will expose this hair that nestles between the pads. I want to remember to pull this down from the top. See, look at what I found. I'm going to push it back out because it probably feels weird. Along the hair between the two last toes. Oh, see how I manipulate the toes to get them out of my way? I put a little bit of pressure between these two fingers and I just rolled my thumb. It just helped give me a little bit more space. Okay, so that's a safer foot. Less slippery on my surfaces. I'm just gonna clean up the shape a little bit. The stuff I see on the outside. I see I got a corner. There we go, nice job, Amores. Here we go, next foot. Again, straight across the toes because I don't want a rounded foot. I want a oval foot. So, down across the top. I'm going to sweep this way, getting stuff that's in between, and I'm going to carry on around to the last two toes. I'm going to separate the toes and get that stuff in between. I'm going to pull the stuff from the top. Yeah. Now I'm going to push these toes out a little bit. Just gives me a little bit. See how I did that? Using a bit of pressure. I'm going to separate these two toes. So I can get a little bit of this, and a little bit of that, and a little bit of this. All right, final shaping. Get off any little bits. Yay, those two are done. Will you bang for me? That's a good girl. So you notice I always start on the lowest foot. And especially in the front, this actually helps keep her shoulder down. Okay, straight across the toes. I'm going to sweep again, getting the hairs that are sticking past the pads. I'm going to get my thumb ready to separate those toes. Maybe I'll start by pulling that hair through. That's it. Stretch the toes out so I can get around the base of them a little bit. Now I'm going to do between the toes. Working my way around. Oh, bada bing, bada boom, right? Go after any strays, cleaning up the shape. All right, Morris, you're almost done. Who's been a great girl? So again, straight across. So I'm holding her foot together because I don't want her helping me. Sometimes they try to spread their toes out. So I'm just sort of hold them together. Oh, did that get you right in the snaws? Sorry, sweetheart. So you see the difference when I hold her toes? Okay, so let's pull the hairs between. Ooh, that one's not too bad. Must have remembered it last time. And across the toes. Now I'm doing my sweep. I need to be double jointed. I'm gonna go after the base of these toes and the in-betweeners. The in-betweeners. And now the shape of the end. That one's bugging me. I couldn't wait to come back and get this guy that was sticking out funny. All right, that's a quick trim. In my series, I've given Lady Amore a quick grooming. I'm now going to do a bit of coat care. Going to spray it down with some water. So here we go. Water, water, water. A little bit under here. A little bit under here. What about here? And here's my cheat. Are you ready? And I have a few of these. These are doggy colognes. I'm going to use this one called Doggone Fresh. I want to spray it in her face, so I'm just going to cover her face a little bit. Uh-oh, I dropped the lid. That's all right. Especially the stinky areas. There we go. So I'm going to start my line brush in. I'm going to give it a quick through. So I don't know if it makes a difference, but girl dogs, have less coat, so it's easier to do sort of quick line brush on them. I'm just getting my pin brush. See, I use a pin brush. Getting my pin brush in here, working quickly, back and forth. Who's a good girl, Morris? This is working some of the water in, making sure that I'm not breaking the coat. Remember, this is just a quick brush. Not doing fancy, just tidying up a little bit. Okay, gotta have the belly parts, since you're famous for your belly rubs. Yeah. Gonna do the business end a little bit. I know, right? Poor little Moors. Okay, gonna come back and do a bit of this neck and ruff. So my dogs have collars on all the time with some form of ID. If that doesn't work for you, that's okay too. We won't talk about that now. We can discuss that in a different video. Poor little Moors. Okay, I'm gonna bring in the slicker brush. If you follow me, you know I have a few styles. Bang, good girl. I have a few styles of slicker brushes I like. Oh, girls are really so easy when they don't have 40 pounds of coat. Yay, Moors! See, I did most of the bulk of the work with the pin brush. I know, right? Now you're gonna be all cute, back in the box. Okay, you sit up. Oh, good girl. I am a good girl. I want to make sure I'm going to pay some attention to the back of the ears, because that's, as we know, a high tangle spot. I want to trim over her cute little, brush over her cute little faces. Yeah. Oh, see, don't lie to me. You like some of these parts, don't ya? Okay, so now I need to flip her over and do the other side. This is how I do that. I'm going to raise her feet, spin her around, flop her over like a hot dog. Tell her she's a good girl. Remember, this is just a quick brush. I'm not doing too much fussing. I did the other leg. I know, right? No fuss. My cheater spray. Doggone fresh. Couple spritzes. Love it. Where's that brush? Here we go. Good girl. What a good girl. What a good girl. Yay. Amore, you're such a good lady. So this dog used to be really stressed about the touching, about the feedies. And I used a lot of the methods that Glenda talks about, getting the dogs desensitized to being touched in their feedies. This dog actually pooped on the grooming table one day when she was a kid. And I was doing her toes and she was so stressed about it. And then I knew that if I was gonna help her maintain a healthy coat, that I was gonna have to help her feel better about all this touchy stuff. So I did some desensitization work and then I regularly groom her just like this. And I think that helps it be short and not as intrusive to her. And I've got some snacks that I'll give her at the end. I did good, little Moors. Okay, getting some of this pin brushing in. I am a good Moors. I am just a good Moors. You know, it's funny, they don't like some of this, but she likes other parts of this, like the belly stuff. And when I put her down, she woo-woos and bounces around. We call it the I survived victory. Okay, will you sit up? Yes, such a good dog. I want to make sure I get her shoulders, her chesty. So when I do a more in-depth grooming, I would take the collar off. But and a quickie, I'm just going to move it around a little bit so I can get underneath it. Yeah, because we don't want no tangles. It's part of the reason I like the royal leather collars. They're the right shape to not break the coat. So that's why I use them. And of course, I leave them on my dogs. So they got identifications. Because I know stuff happens. All right, Morris. Down, please. She survived. Feety nails. Foot trim. A brush in. I'm a good girl. Thanks for watching.